welcome to my living room. I just wanted to do like a chill chit-chat video today because I'm kind of tired and I gotta go to Houston tomorrow, so I gotta pack soon. But I want to give y'all an update and then also show you a couple of pieces that I got from Fashion Nova, which I haven't had the chance to show you yet. I'll try it on and everything later. But first, I finally dyed my hair. I've been wanting to do this for a while because my ends are so orange. I don't even know if you can tell that I dyed my hair. And the reason why it was so orange is because I've dyed my hair so many times. So like, I don't even know what kind of chemical, like, disaster was happening. I dyed my hair like a really light brown and then tried to cover it up with a dark brown, and I guess the dark brown got washed out, so I was just left with like a section of orange hair. So today I used the Garnier Nutrisse dark brown. I just picked it up at random at Walgreens. I probably should have done my research because I'm like a walking example of how hair dyes can go really, really wrong. And I think it came out really nice. It matches my hair pretty good because I only put the hair dye in the orange section. I didn't want to cover my natural roots with more hair dye. This is my natural roots, like my natural hair color. And this is where I dyed it. Like, you can't really see the difference. It kind of blends in together, so thank God. Also, I said I was gonna vlog Pudding's birthday, but Julia ended up calling us and she needed our help, so we went to her place to help her move in. So we didn't end up doing a whole bunch for Pudding's birthday. This is the teepee we got her. When we first got it and we like set it up, she wouldn't even go in. Like, we would throw treats in there and her toys. Trinh and I had to pull the teepee together so that Pudding couldn't leave to like keep her in there. But thank God she started sleeping in it because it wasn't cheap. And now she doesn't come out. She just stays in there all day. On the first night we set this up, because this is like her own house, I wanted to make it cute, so I gave her like my faux sheepskin. You know the white furry rug you can get at IKEA? I put it right here so she could have like a lawn. And she peed on it the first night. Anyway, y'all probably don't care about any of this. I'm gonna show you my haul. So this is the first thing I got. The jeans aren't from there, it's from a guest outlet. It's basically just a simple cropped white button-up with a tie back. I picked it up because it's a dupe for one of those RUMI tops that are like $80. I also love wearing white button-ups. I have like three in my closet, but I wanted something that's a little cuter, just something different and less boring. And it also has this flare sleeve. The only thing I don't like about this top is you have to wear those stick-on sticky bras. And like, I can wear them, but I would prefer not to. If there's any option, like if there's any way I can hide bra straps in a way where I don't need to just wear sticky bra, I would do it. It's just I sweat a lot and I'm not really sure how to properly clean them. Oh, I forgot to show you, this is a sticky bra. I actually also got this from Fashion Nova a while ago. It was like $5 or $6. It was really cheap when I got it, and it's basically the same thing as those $30 ones that you would be able to find on Instagram. They're all the same manufacturer and you really don't need to pay that much for, you know, two pieces of cutlets with stickers. This top is kind of unusual for me. I never wear anything like it. Trinh hates it, but I think it's so cute. Like the button detail and the ring belts. Like, the ring belt is actually what drew me to this top because ring belts are so on trend. Everybody's wearing them and it's kind of formal. It's kind of conservative, but it's still like, you know, give you some curve. If I had a sugar daddy, this is what I would wear to his funeral. I don't know why Trinh hates it. I think it's so cute. Also, this ring belt is not sewn in, so it's detachable, so you can wear it with something else. And I'm wearing this with these jeans. These jeans are also from Fashion Nova. They're kind of like this dark charcoal, a faded black pair of jeans. I don't know if I've said this before, but Fashion Nova is my favorite place to get jeans because they're super stretchy. I really wish they did more of like mom jeans or boyfriend jeans. I actually have two more pairs of Fashion Nova jeans in my closet right now. I just like them so much and they're really form-fitting. Like, this pair, when I first got them, they were a little bit tight on me and I thought I would have to return them, but then I wore them like two more times and they like kind of morphed into the shape of my legs. The same thing happened with my other pair. When I first got them, they were too loose. And somehow now when I pull them up, they just fits my body perfectly. But yeah, I think they're so cute. I love them. Oh, I also styled this pair of jeans in my outfit diaries video. Okay, last thing I got is this dress. I kind of thought the material was gonna be better. It's kind of like slinky. Like, it's not even jersey. It's like a slinky. So like, if you feel it, you know it's not like made out of great quality, but it's still a really cute dress. As with all my dresses, I have no idea where I'm gonna wear this to. Maybe for Thanksgiving, but I feel like if I wore this, all the aunties are gonna have a heart attack. I think my favorite part about this dress is the asymmetrical sleeve, because one is up here and the other is kind of like off shoulder, so it's kind of like Okay. Oh, one more thing. I got this bag from FashionNova as well. I cannot deal with how cute this bag is. I've already used it like 2-3 times. I love the ring detail. It kind of reminds me of the Chloe Faye bag. It's not a dupe or anything. It's obviously a completely different bag, but just the ring detail and the chain with the two different black textures. I just think it's such a nice sturdy bag. You can also wear this as a backpack or like how I'm wearing it now. And the inside is lined with red fabric, which I didn't expect. I'm gonna be wearing this bag so much.
So that's everything I got. I'm getting so sweaty from all the changing. Anyway, I have one more thing to tell y'all. Me and Trinh are going to Houston early tomorrow. I think I already told you that. Part of the reason why we're going is because we're going to this clinic called Laser Away. They asked me if I'd be interested in getting any of their services in exchange for like a dedicated video on YouTube. They had a bunch of stuff like Botox and lip injections and hair removal, which I'm already in the process of doing, so I didn't even consider that. And Coolsculpting, which is what I went with. I'm gonna do my stomach area, and I'm gonna do like before afters and like film the whole process so y'all can see like what it's like. I'm really excited because Laser Away is like a very trusted, like popular clinic. Like Kim Kardashian got laser hair removal there, so I'm guessing they're pretty good. I chose Coolsculpting mostly because I want to show y'all like if it works. I wasn't actively looking for like a beauty treatment, but I kind of wanted to be, you know, your guinea pig. But when I was looking through their list of services, it made me think maybe they have something for Trinh, because if you're subscribed to his channel or watch his vlogs, you know that he recently had surgery. I say recently, but it's been how long? It's actually been half a year. It just went by so fast. He had top surgery, which means he had like a huge scar across his chest, and it's been getting a lot better. It's faded substantially because laser scar removal really isn't cheap, especially when it's like a surgical scar. So Trinh never got it done because it's quite a lot of money, but he's been dying to try it. So in my business emails, I was just kind of like, can you do Trinh too? And Laser Away was so nice. Like, I really didn't expect them to. I kind of just, you know, suggested it as kind of like a shot in the dark. I think they mostly agreed out of kindness, which is great. So tomorrow I'll meet the people there. Me and Trinh will both get our individual consultations, kind of like a spa date. So yeah, I'm very excited about that, and I'll film both of our treatments so y'all can see our results. I just knocked over the Windex. Anyway, thank you for listening to me. Oh, one more thing. I read all of your comments, and I know y'all been really liking the philosophy video. Obviously, it didn't get as many views as my regular makeup videos, but so many people really liked it. They told me in comments, they messaged me. So I'm not giving up on that. It's just those kind of videos tend to take longer to plan, so I won't be able to do them weekly, and also balancing school and other videos. So there will definitely be more of them. I just wanted to plan them more carefully so it's like content worth watching. It's not just like a repetition of information that you can get by just googling. And I hope y'all have a very, very fun Thanksgiving. It'll be my last Thanksgiving because after this year I'll be moving back to Hong Kong, so it's kind of sad. But I'm just very eager to see Trinh's family again. I haven't seen them in so long, and all the cousins. If I don't upload a video until after Thanksgiving, I hope y'all have a very happy, fun Thanksgiving. Anyway, thank you for listening to me ramble on. I'll see you next week. Bye!